I'm Alan Hall and welcome to WeatherGuard. Here at WeatherGuard, we make lightning protection easy. A common weather radar problem that we see all the time on nose radomes. And I'm going to give you a couple of examples here and walk through them. Basically, what happens on nose radomes, as the aircraft gets electrified, as it flies around thunderstorms, as it passes closer and closer to an electrified cloud, the ends of the radome, the very front of the radome, gets electrified, and there starts to be high voltage effects start to take place. There's going to be high voltage streamers. Maybe there's something called leaders happening. So basically, electrical charge is leaving the aircraft and going out in space. This can be a problem for nose radomes in particular. And I want to show you two examples. I think one is an Airbus, the other one's a Boeing airplane. It's not aircraft specific, but the concept is the same, which is you see these pit marks show up on the front of the radome. So if you go look here, and we'll provide these details, on this red radome, you see there's little white marks, little pop marks on the radome. That's a problem where the paint has actually been pushed off the radome from electrical charge jumping off the radome. Same thing here for this Boeing airplane. This Boeing airplane has taken a lightning strike. So you see the black area, which is the anti-static paint, showing in an area is probably the size of a soccer ball, maybe a little bit bigger, where the paint has been removed on the aircraft. That's another indication the aircraft has been in lightning strike or near lightning strike conditions. The problem that this creates for the aircraft is once that paint comes off, that the protective coating comes off, the radome is much more susceptible to water ingressing into the core of the radome and then causing further damage to the radome from the freeze-thaw from takeoff and landing. So we like to keep the paint on the radome. One thing about keeping the paint on the radome, you can keep the paint on the radome by where you put the lightning protection. And in this particular case, both these radomes, as we show here, use metal bars, and the metal bars do work for lightning protection, but the metal bars are not where the lightning activity is happening on the radome. So they're too far back, they're pulled too far back from the front of the radome. Here at WeatherGuard, with our StrikeTape product, we like to put our StrikeTape up toward the front of the radome. That will minimize a lot of these pop marks you see from the anti-static paint showing up and the outer coatings popping off, because the energy and the activity lightning wise happens at the strike tape. So our design recommendations a lot of times is if they want to improve an existing radome, like a 737 or Airbus 319, 320 kind of aircraft, one way to get rid of these pop marks that happen on the front of the radome is add strike tape. Bring the lightning protection to where the lightning activity is happening on the radome. Makes a big difference on the lifetime of the radome, can extend the lifetime years in some cases, depending on the applications. And here at WeatherGuard, we're all about making lightning radome protection simple and easy. We've been doing it for a long time. If you need help with your radome lightning protection system, give us a call today.